Susan Bradley here for CSO Online. I wanted to bring to your attention something I spotted in a recent Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection Alert. They talked about a zero-day flash that was used in a spear phishing attack. Adobe released a zero-day patch for this on December 5th of 2018. The target attack was against a medical institution in Russia. The vulnerability, titled up CVE-2018-15982, had an interesting attack sequence. And it highlighted to me a number of mitigations that one should use to block such attacks. The attack started with the spear phishing attack. As the site NoB4 points out, a whopping 91% of cyber attacks and resulting data breaches begin with a spear phishing email. Spear phishing email is actually a targeted email at a specific individual or department within an organization that appears to be from a trusted source. As a result, it's very hard to defend. It's not impossible, but it is hard to defend. So here's how this attack played out. The spear phishing email consisted of a RAR archive file containing two files. The first was a lure document, an enticing email, and the second was an archive file disguised as a JPEG file. Once the user opened the document, the embedded ActiveX flash control was activated. That ran a command script that unzipped the archive file and ran the payload. In this instance, a scheduled task was created to start a backdoor whenever the user logged in. It collected vital system information and then uploaded that information to a hard-coded command and control IP address server every 5 minutes. The backdoor was set to be able to receive instructions that could be loaded into memory. There are several ways you can mitigate this attack as well as defend a little bit more and also review your email account to see if it's been compromised. Some of the more usual ways that you can determine if your account has been compromised is you determine that you see suspicious activity. Other users in your environment receive emails from the compromised account. You see inbox rules that you didn't set. The user display name might be changed. The user's mailbox is blocked from sending email. The sent folders contain common hacked account messages like, I'm stuck here, send money. There's been unusual profile changes, unusual credential changes, mail forwarding has been added. Again, anything that just seems odd, and make sure you empower your end users to tell you of unusual events they see in their mailbox. Next, you obviously want to patch for the exploit, but again, we can't always have patches available, so we also need to know what things to do to protect just in case. For example, on Windows 10, you can enable the Windows Defender System Guard and exploit protection capabilities in Windows 10. Next, you can turn on cloud delivered protection and automatic sample submission in Windows Defender Antivirus. This uses artificial intelligence and machine learning to identify new patterns. And of course, you want to make sure your Office ATP settings are available, Advanced Threat Protection. You want to make sure the Advanced Threat Protection Safe Links and Advanced Protection settings for the Safe Sends are set. You want to turn on attack surface reduction rules in Windows 10 to limit the executable activity. You may need to review if you're licensed and enabled to do this. You will need Windows Defender ATP and require Windows 10 Enterprise E5. Bottom line, I want you to think about in terms of when you will be attacked, not if you will be attacked. If you plan with that in mind, you will be safer in the long run. So now, before you are at risk, think of all of the ways that you can harden your systems. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online Insider.